The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Power Trading Hour with your host, David White. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, David White.
And welcome, everyone. I hope I can hear myself. There I am. To another excellent edition of the Power Trading Hour. It doesn't matter whether you're in San Bernardino or having martinis with Dan Marino. Keep them coming. We're glad to have you here at this time.
The following takes place between 2 p.m. and 3 p.m.
So what do we have today? Well, we're up 18 on the S&P cash, Dow 30 up 66. It was down 100 earlier in the day. NASDAQ had gone down to maybe minus 10 or 20 or something like that. Up 80 at the moment. Russell was down 10, up about 6 now. So we had a try to blow out the bottom. Wasn't a lot of volume there. Volume not much to the upside either. But I sit here with no position, either long or short. Although I am thinking that, like everybody knows, that this will end, and it will end badly. I'm not exactly sure when it's going to start, but I have a feeling it's going to be a sell-off when it does start off until May. But in the meantime, we're just grinding through this 38.50 level on the S&P cash. And the longer you hold here, the more likely that it's going to just gap up higher. And now, if it fails, then you short it. If it just goes up there and turns right around, if it pops, it'll probably pull back a little bit. You try to buy the dip. But this, I went through the numbers around noon, and they had been decidedly fairly bearish. They went to kind of a 50-50 about noon when I ran that. So could we just go sideways for a while? Certainly could. Getting into options expiration, and hopefully this month we're going to have enough puts that I can actually get something. Expiration's on the 19th of February. So we've got a few things going on like that. Now, the big things that I'm looking at are that there are very few short positions. We talked about Tesla having almost none when it had, 10, 15 days to cover, 20 days to cover a year ago. Can't get a one day to cover. Can't get anybody to short even in a day for the most part. And we'll look at that. If it closes down below about, what is it now? Yeah, about 855. It's at 857 now. So it's just a couple of bucks, but down 15 bucks. We talked about that yesterday. Pretty good setup for a double repo pattern. So you want to see what that goes. Now, the downside, I would be short this thing already, but I looked at some puts, and I think there were 40 or 50 bucks for out of the money puts at, I think, 825 or something. It was just nuts. I mean, you're not going to make money on them. No one's buying puts, and it may be because they're so expensive. I think you just would have to ladder into the thing. But either that, you're looking at about 690 on it. Anyway, TLT and bonds. I suspect if you see a TLT at 148, that's going to tell you everything you need to know. Right now, it's right at 150. That 148 is probably the first support. But most things in the market don't matter until they matter. My guess is below 150, they're going to start mattering. Now, there is the opinion that as money comes out of bonds, it's going to go into the equity markets. We can see the volume has not been anything compared to the volume down when we went to 3,700-ish and moved back higher. But it was quick. Now, you know, this is not, this is a pattern that actually can go either way. That's why I am all cash at the moment. But you know what? We'll have to wait. I don't know if it's a good idea to start predicting which way it's going to break. As I said, it's at least my numbers are 50-50. And I don't make a living flipping quarters. But just keep a look at it. When we look at the volume, as we said, on the way down, we had 22, 24 billion shares. Today, we're up on about 9.4 billion shares. So if you're thinking bullish, I think that there's a couple of scenarios. One, we have some kind of monster news, which I don't think is coming. More than likely, we just sit here and grind it out for a while and gain the energy to go higher. The opposite side is someone drops the chalupa, and we see that bond market make a giant sucking sound. In fact, what do we have here? Is it in there? Yes. We went to the ghost of Ross Perot and asked him what he thinks the market's going to do.
There will be a giant sucking sound.
Yes, a giant sucking sound. So we'll continue to look at that. But, you know, outside chance, we go right to 4,000. Market gives it up, and then that's it. Of course, the higher you go without a decent retrace and some consolidation, the worse it's going to be. The old saying is that you can stretch a rubber band. The more you stretch it before it breaks, the more it's going to hurt. And we really, really need that, along with a Fed that probably gets rid of what we have now, which is, I wouldn't say just kind of a Greenspan-y irrational exuberance. I'd say we're darn incredibly nutty, especially in a lot of these. But of course, that only lasts a short time, and then you see the other side of it. And of course, as much as these guys at Reddit and YouTube and Robinhood have pushed the market up, if it starts going down, we can rely on them to do an equal job of creaming a company. So, and just keep an eye on that. We've got a lot of stuff. We're going to go to Chad, Maryland. How you doing, Chad?
I'm doing good. How are you?
Good. We're going to go to the break in about 20, 30 seconds. What do we want to talk about today?
I would like to ask you about the APHA Tilray merger. I'm new. I was just on the last show, and when Aphria acquires Tilray, I'm going to get a percentage of the shares, but Tilray trades higher than Aphria. So how does that work?
Well, I'm not a big guy in that part of the business. We want to hang on
sure.
Through the break. We'll talk on the other side. And, yeah, we'll be back.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I will personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
And we're back talking about Tilray and is it Aphria? Is that how you pronounce it? Not much going on in here. I've gone through a lot, and I'm going to have to find the prospectus to see how this actually works out. Apparently, this is extremely complicated, because generally, when you read through these, you can find it right away. But apparently, this has something to do with Tilray being under its IPO price. But ma'am, I think you have to be a lawyer to figure this one out. It is not easy. So I can understand your phone call.
In five days, I have seen each share go up substantially over $5 or trading at close to 17 now. And I started at 12.
Yeah. I mean, if you're not familiar with it, we've got Chuck Schumer telling everybody that it's time to light up. We'll make it legal. But I think he said that even if they did, it's 2 years away. I don't know why it would take 2 years. I mean, they run the Senate, they run the House, they can do anything they want. But,
I just wonder if, because I'm completely new to this, if the cannabis industry, it's up and rising, and I'm very supportive of it myself because I'm a veteran, so I actually use it. I want to make sure that I'm going to go in the right route. I always felt like commodities was the way to go.
Well, I'll tell you what I've said since day one, when this Tilray was $300, I said the same thing. And there is a company that's coming out with earnings tonight. Do you know what the name of that company is? It's been it's been the best performer over time. Starts with somebody's first name. It's called Scott's Miracle-Gro.
Okay. Well, they're investing into the cannabis industry as well, I think.
Well, mostly they're in the fertilizer part of it, right?
Right, so correct.
Other things.
Which there's another
everything.
Company, which is like Canistart or something, and they provide all the materials for it to be grown.
Right. Now, when Tilray was going to 7 and at 300. I said the exact same thing. And that is generally when you talk about stuff like gold, everybody thinks there's a gold, gold rush, right? The companies that historically have all made the big money weren't the gold companies. They were the people that made the picks and shovels, and a little company called that made jeans and overalls. None of the companies that really were in the gold rush of California or Alaska are still around. Levi Strauss, still a big name. Right now, Scott's Miracle-Gro spiked to 250 and gave it all up pre-earnings. But I think that's after the bell tonight, if I'm not mistaken. I always said that no matter what you want to get into, and this has been for 2 years, when everybody starts talking about, you know, marijuana or something like that, or anything else, we'll say it's like semiconductors. Who actually, you know, the people that shipped them were pretty good, like NVIDIA. But over time, the companies that actually made the products that made the chips all did, you know, historically much better than the companies that actually made the chips, right? So one good question is always, now you pretty much have a pretty monstrous ABC in Miracle-Gro. But to me, I like that play better from back in the round when it was around 100 to now. I don't know the weed industry that well. And, you know, to me, it's always been this. And anybody that wants to can call in or chime in. But I think for forever, I've been saying that what you want to do is look at companies that are around marijuana, because they're probably on a percentage basis going to do a lot better over the long term. Now, in the short term, everybody's sure they're going to I think the Tilray guy was out running around saying that he talked to U.S. politicians and was sure that within 2 years it was going to happen. I don't know. But I do know that, you know, without that legality, there's still a lot of problems. Like these companies, how they collect cash, them having bank accounts. Scott's Miracle-Gro never had that one, right? It did business. It collected stuff. The DEA was never knocking at its door. All it did was sell fertilizer. I like that play almost every time better than the rest of them. And why it's up, you have to remember Tilray's off $300. So those ones that
and
go.
The only other one my father's had me looking at is OCGN. He told me to look into it because I guess they just went with the COVID test. So it's going to be, he feels it's going to be going up, but I don't feel that way. I have a few shares of it, but I don't know if you could take a look at that and see what you think.
Which one?
OCGN.
Okay. I'll take a look. Scott's Miracle-Gro was out this morning, excuse me. So it's on my list here. I knew it was either out tonight or this morning. It's actually in my list here of stocks to go through when we get off the line with you. One more with a ticker.
OCGN.
OCGN?
GN, correct.
OCGN, okay. Ocugen, huh?
Correct.
Okay, so it's a penny stock. It had a big gap higher. Preserve on news or earnings? You know what that was?
No. Okay. What I know is that they were just approved by the UE to start providing COVID tests to India.
Okay, so it's news. Clinical stage focus on discovery, commercialization of transport therapies to cure blindness. Company's novel fusion protein that's in preclinical development stage for treatment of wet AMD, diabetic. So it's all about eyes and how that stuff works. Don't know why or how much money they're actually going to make in the COVID part of it, but I have a feeling that what people like about that is as a penny stock, you're always worried about them going out and getting more cash. It's kind of nice that they're actually out there trying to make some, right, that they can turn into whatever product they're going to have someday. Anyway, not enough volume here on a daily basis, you know, after a couple of months. But if it doesn't have more than about 300,000 on average each day, I find it incredibly hard to have any prediction actually be any good. You know, are you in this right now, you said?
Correct.
Yeah, I don't see anything.
I'm only into it for about 400 shares, so I'm not into it deep.
Yeah, I just put a stop in and let it ride. Thanks for the call. We'll be back in a minute.
If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Yeah. Questions on DM. For some reason, my feed doesn't have any data on it. I'm going to have to go back and find out. I think we brought it up before, and that was the same thing. So I don't have a great deal to say about it right now. I'm not exactly sure why that one doesn't come up on the feed. Stocks with earnings. You have a nice little pop here today in a bevy, ABBV. These are all earnings from last night and this morning. And not much in the way of volume to write home about. It's just going up against a gap down from a few days ago. No big deal there. Amgen, fairly nice recovery from opening lower, but only about half of it. Not much going on in that one either, other than this does look like it would go around to 218, 215, maybe 208. But certainly it looks like it's peaked now. Amazon, I thought this one would whiff last night. I confused the pattern, the intraday action, very much like what I saw on Apple. And, of course, it's all about the current CEO and him leaving. I think he said 6 months. Maybe that's right, something like that. Third quarter, second quarter or something. He's going to go off and compete in the satellite business and rockets. I have a feeling he's get kind of tired and looking forward to what's going to be happening. Probably not unjustly. I don't think he wants to spend the rest of his life talking to people and lawyers about court cases because they're starting to stack up on Amazon antitrust issues. For him, he's going to be Amsgray Attenlay by the time all the proverbial excrement hits the fan for what's coming down the road on these guys. He sees it and he's out the door. So, you know what? More power to him, but going somewhere else. He had a doji yesterday, got a little bit of a pop this morning, gave it mostly up. But I thought maybe they were going to whiff the way that it had been kind of acting, that they tried to push it up yesterday into the earnings, which has not been good. Generally, you want everybody being a little bearish on this. Everybody was bullish into earnings yesterday, so not surprised that it didn't go very far. I already had a couple of questions from people asking me about what the new CEO is going to be like. He's from the Amazon Web Services or clouds part of the business. One of the things about being outside of Silicon Valley, like Microsoft and Amazon, is that you don't have a lot of people writing or knowing a lot about other than Bezos and what he's doing. But the guy seems to be competent in the Amazon Web Services part, kind of telling that Bezos is going to give him the reins instead of somebody from, you know, the other divisions, you know, selling stuff and delivering it door to door. This is the big margin product that they have, and probably the one that's going to be in the biggest trouble going forward. I don't think you can do a lot other than hire lawyers for their antitrust issue, but I think they're going to have to work real hard getting trust back in the Amazon Web Services. A lot of countries across the globe are now pretty much saying that they want intrinsic cloud services in their own country, run by their own companies. They no longer, after they saw what Amazon did and other big tech companies did, right or wrong if you're sitting in the United States, but definitely wrong if you're sitting outside the United States, because they think that could be done to them. You could put them all out of business or the country out of business. Or don't let the current Prime Minister of Australia say something. These guys don't like that at all. And Amazon's going to have a tough road. This may be one of these things like when Ballmer came on with Microsoft in 2002 or 2003, the company went sideways for 10 years. I don't think there's a lot intrinsically wrong with Amazon. It may pull back a bit. But you may be in that same kind of position where Ballmer was hired to keep the stock price from moving too much. Why every single week Bill Gates was selling and selling and selling. Oh, we didn't get to do our history thing, which we'll do right now because it was actually about Bill Gates. Just a little bit of history.
history repeating.
On this day in 1986, the term vaporware was first used by Philip DeWitt in a Time magazine article. The term is now commonly used to describe software that had been long announced but hadn't been released. At the time, many experts believed Microsoft was guilty of using vaporware announcements to keep its customers from purchasing software from other companies. And it was. By convincing them that Microsoft's version was just around the corner, I was there for the Comdex November display in 86, watched the entire thing, stood in line over at the snack bar in the Las Vegas Convention Center with Bill Gates in front of me complaining to the lady how much the hot dog cost, and Steve Jobs standing behind me trying to convince somebody that no one needed a color monitor for a Mac, because of course they didn't have one. So everybody was spin, spin, spin. But earlier that day, I went to the keynote, and Bill Gates was destined to be what people call in the industry a demo god. He was basically showing Word and Excel as a competitor to Lotus 1-2-3, which was all the same thing, your email, spreadsheets and your documents and other things like that. Well, there were 3,000 or over 3,000 known bugs that would have caused the blue screen of death. Bill Gates actually transposed every one of them, missed them. He had been preparing for 5 days to make the demo work. And if he did everything absolutely perfectly, nothing would happen. And, of course, that's exactly what he did. It was 3 years later before the product came out. Yes, he was able to freeze the market. And the term vaporware became ubiquitous probably through about 2000. And then if you didn't have a product, people just didn't care anymore. It was the first rat to the cheese. No one was waiting. And it moved on. Anyway. Okay, let's get back to some charts here that we were talking about. As I said, Amazon probably okay, but just looks like this thing's trapped in a trading range for a while. BIIB. Little gap down and not a lot of volume. Kind of like the whole market up there, just a little up, a little down, but nobody really saying a great deal. Okay. Come on. Okay, we're up 20 points on the S&P cash. 38.47. Dow's up 96. NASDAQ's up 83. Up 80. Crude up 91 cents. We'll be back.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I will personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get that competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
And we got a question from who today? Hector, about NVIDIA. Is it time to buy here? The problem with NVIDIA is that it can't produce the kind of volume it needs to get any higher. They have a lot of video cards. A lot of people, including me, have orders for them. And guess what? We're now, I put an order, in October? Still haven't seen hide nor hair in it. It's on a lottery system now. If they actually could deliver what they have built, it would be fairly amazing. But they've got problems in the supply. They got problems in manufacturing. And they're not the only one. AMD is kind of the same thing. Now, I have to say, if they ever get any of this stuff out the door, NVIDIA is a $1,000 company. The problem is that they can't get it out the door. Advanced Micro is not all that different. They are just not selling to a high-end company. But I don't see anything here that says it's time to act. Now, on NVIDIA, I got to play with something last week that is just truly amazing from NVIDIA. And I'll talk to Tom about it on Friday. But these guys continue to have very expensive hardware. I got to play with a $5,000 video card. Think about that. A video card that's 5Gs. And there's a reason for it. But we'll talk about that with Tom on Friday. A little teaser out there. But some really neat stuff. But if you think of NVIDIA as the video card company, I think you can. But you can also think about them as a scientific computing company. And they are really going after these guys with a lot of cash in institutions like colleges, teaching machine learning, and Fortune 500 companies. Again, they're doing well or better than they should because they're turning a lot of the stuff that they would give to us miscreants wanting to play video games. I actually have a use for it other than that. But there's a reason why these things are kind of trapped in their time frame, and that is when these things start moving, it will probably mean that manufacturing has gotten on the stick, both in the supply chain for the chips that they get, the products. But people haven't really talked about it. There's even a shortage of copper foil for the printed circuit boards that they have. There's constraints everywhere in the semiconductor space. And like I said, this is a company that can sell everything that it can manufacture. It just, for a variety of reasons, can't manufacture it. So as soon as that changes, I think you'll see it in the stock price. But everybody's just wondering how much money they're actually making selling the stuff if half of it ends up being thrown in the dustbin. But we shall see. Tune in Friday. That's what they call a tease in the industry. But pretty cool stuff. BSX for earnings. Boston Scientific up a bit, decent volume. Didn't really make any new highs or lows. On the downside of what's going on here today, Checkpoint Software looks to me like it's blown through the two big days that went up back right before Christmas of 2020. Looks to me like after this, with the volume they've got, you're probably looking back down to 11.15, 11.12, somewhere in that range. It'll probably have to take a while to chew through 117, but it does look like this thing would go back to 112. Doesn't look good. Chipotle, just a little spinning top out here. Not good. When you look at that 15.53.55 sitting up there all by itself, you would have liked that it didn't get quite up there on today's Joji. But a lot of black boxes are going to be looking at that pattern right there and say maybe something's up. I'm not willing to say that quite yet, but it is certainly, just for the pattern on earnings, not a good one. And I don't know. Electronic Arts, another one on the loser horn, got to 138.04 at a low today. Still not good. It's not the end of the world. But should have seen better in that one. EVR, which is Evercore, tried to break to new highs, couldn't do it. Looks like it's going to close back into the trading range. Got to 126.58, currently trading out at 120.95, which is, what was the high of that day? 121.46. So it is back into the trading range. Nothing going on in there. FireEye, everybody keeps waiting for them to get bought out. They kind of overheated on being the ones to figure out the last big hack. But back on not bad volume today at $20.04. You'd love for this thing to probably hit about $19. That would be fairly nice. Let's see if anybody's been shorting that. Because, of course, the reason it really took off is a combination of the news and massive short selling. Today, no, nobody's really short selling it right now. It went from pre this big move, it went from 6.5 days to cover. To 1 day to cover. So there aren't a lot of shorts in this. They haven't come back in, and I don't see them on a daily basis coming back in and doing something. In fact, the last big day this thing was even kind of shorted was back on the 23rd of December. So, yeah, I'm going to say 19 to 18, you get that hit, and you get the continuing light volume. That's where you want to probably take your first look at FireEye. HUM, which is Humana, not really doing much other than staying in the trading range. It's below the December 31st, or was below the December 21st low at 380.66. Got to 373.57 today. You got some decent volume. Did open lower. It is a little bit more into the trading range. Right now, 384.08. A close back in the trading range would be a little something, but I don't think it's a whole lot. Actually, kind of weak. Lithia Motors, again, not a lot of movement out here in this one. Just kind of hanging on to the side. LGND, which is Ligand Pharmaceuticals. This thing had quite the run up into earnings. Huge volume days. Just a doji with no volume today. They call it a spinning top. Match Group, This is one you want to keep a close eye on because, let's get this out here. You are right at the level where if this thing does close, where it's at right now, tomorrow's candle would probably be a big down candle. I guess support comes back in at about 122, currently trading out at 140.86.
Back in the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006, and like many of you, was drawn in by, as well as,
whatever you think about, you bring about, whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us, and Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab. Bam!
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your two-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today.
Catch Tom O'Brien, professional trader and educator, founder of TFNN, also a special guest on CNBC. Tom will bisect and dissect the markets. The Tom O'Brien Show, next on TFNN.
And it's pretty much we got Sony had a blowout quarter for PlayStations. Huge breakout, a pullback to about 105-ish on light volume might be a play when it comes back, but a very good day for them. After the bell tonight, we've got PayPal, Qualcomm, Digital Turbine, eBay, Netgear, Align Technologies, Grubhub, Qorvo. I think we got a few more in that vein for cellular phones, too. In the semi space, we have Clack. That's about it for tonight. Now, tomorrow morning, we have Nokia, Clorox, Philip Morris, Quest Diagnostics, Penn National Gaming, Merck & Company, Bristol Myers. So a little bit for you BBH fans, Yum Brands. who have mostly been working on what they make in China. I haven't watched them lately. I don't know what's going on in that. So you got pretty much that for tomorrow morning. Tomorrow night, you've got Snap, Peloton, and Active, Pinterest, Activision, Blizzard, Gilead Science, Ford Motor Company, Twist Bioscience, T-Mobile. So you're going to get a real taste of both the Silicon and, of course, the actual folks themselves in the cellular business like T-Mobile. You've got Zendesk tomorrow night, too, WWE, which hadn't been a big deal. But we shall see. Anyway, that's about it for today. Again, best estimate is sideways for me. I don't see a lot of action in the markets, but maybe you get some surprise news. But right now, just think we're kind of stuck around here. Either we fail at this level or we hop over it one day. But, either one, I think cash is not a bad position to be in. Looking at the bigger picture. Anyway, see you tomorrow. Same bat channel, same bat time. Remember to sell when you can.